respected brothers and sisters, it gives me immense pleasure to address you all on the occasion of the International Education E-Conference on the theme Holistic Education for Excellence in Life. Education cannot be effective unless it helps a child open up himself to life. This famous quote from the last century is more relevant today in the 21st century because academic excellence alone can no longer assure success and happiness in life and career. Holistic development through education from the early stage of a child's life has become more important today, especially in the midst of crisis that we are facing today. Holistic development essentially means the development of intellectual, mental, physical, emotional, and spiritual capabilities in a child so that he or she is capable of facing the demands and challenges of everyday life. These abilities are virtually important for success in professional fields of work. As Mahatma Gandhi said, if we want to read real peace in this world, we should start educating our children. Every child is unique. Each of them have unique personality traits, interests, preference, values, attitudes, strength, and weaknesses. Real education is what helps every child find his or her unique place in the world in alignment with their innate values. In order to achieve this, the holistic development of a child is of utmost importance. This is a changing time. We are seeing today where our children are being exposed to higher level of stress, anxiety, and uncertainty about the future from their parents and caregivers, but also by themselves. Children are living in constrained environments of fear and uncertainty. Learned thinkers are predicting that the world that would emerge from the ruins of this deadly disease would be a completely different world, quite unlike the world we have seen and experienced before. Our personal, professional, and social lives will go through a metamorphosis and perhaps a new set of personal, professional, or social norms will soon be in place to guide us, to help us find the new normal, as some thinkers would like to call the emerging pandemic shift. How do we support the spiritual well-being of our young children in this changing world scenario when their optimum development would be affected? In time of unprecedented fear, anxiety, and uncertainty, it perhaps the best way forward to have a hard look at the perils of our modern civilization and the rush for mindless specialization in education, and refocus on the concept of man-making or life-giving education, envisaged by sages and spiritual thinkers from time immemorial. As Swami Vivekananda said, education is the manifestation of perfection present already in man. Divinity is the manifestation of the religion already in man. We must recognize the importance of a holistic education and turn the crisis we are going through into an opportunity to recalibrate our education system and aim for a truly comprehensive education which incorporates the aspects of spirituality and divine values. It is time that students are made to connect to the beauty within and to realize the true inner power through spiritual wisdom and meditation. This will help them in the following ways: having a sense of meaning in life, loving and being loved, having self-esteem, a sense of their own worth, tapping into inner peace and joy, being of service to others, having a generosity of spirit. If students are trained to focus on clear goals and realize their purpose of life rather than wandering aimlessly in the wonderland of the cyber world, then we can harness their treasures and develop the young minds, the future citizens of this world, into holistic learners and complete human beings. I appreciate the efforts of Brahma Kumaris for spreading divinity in the society by teaching spiritual and moral values, and I hope this international education e-conference will surely go a long way in establishing a new and beautiful world, a world where there is peace, love and happiness. As Dalai Lama said, when educating the minds of our youth, we must not forget to educate their hearts. Thank you all. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat, Om Shanti.